Hi everybody, welcome to today's podcast. For the final podcast of the first season, I want to discuss gender stereotyping when it comes to children, specifically when companies market to kids. Gender stereotyping is extremely common, as we've established through the course of this season, and it's used in our everyday lives. For children, these stereotypes become very, very clear when it comes to children's toys, children's clothing, books, kids' television programs. It is literally everywhere. And what I mean by this exactly is, and I know I've said this in every podcast so far, but it definitely sticks to the old family traditions with the young girls playing with makeup, dolls, and being raised to, in a way, prepare themselves for motherhood and their future families. All, of course, while being surrounded by beautiful, what could be classed as girly colours, like your pinks. When it comes to young boys, their stereotype colour tends to be blue and green as well. And the stereotype of the boys' toys are things like dinosaurs, cars, action men. Stereotypically, young boys are portrayed as being much more boisterous than girls, who are seen as often being much more sensitive and gentle in nature. For children's programs, often, you know, if the target audience is little girls, you'll see perhaps princesses or something a little more slow-paced compared to their counterparts, who appear to have a lot more action-based shows and toys. When it comes to clothing, the aesthetic is very similar. Boys tend to be brown, blue, very dapper in their looks, and have maybe a car or a tractor printed on the front of them. Not to mention the quotes of how cheeky typical young boys tend to be. Girls, however, it's totally different. It's the complete opposite. For girls, it tends to be pinks, reds, with perhaps some glitter thrown in there, with a picture of a unicorn on their clothing or some cutesy quote. To me, it's very, very apparent that, again, and I know I've mentioned this previously, but it seems like we're in a world where, although we are trying to move on and be more open, traditions and stereotypes are holding us back from developing. I mean, when I was younger, I remember having a girly side, but also being very much like a tomboy and being quite boyish. And some people did have a problem with that as I was growing up and thought that it was unusual or out of the ordinary for a girl to be so interested in toys and shows that were stereotypically meant for young boys. When I was a kid, video games were very much a boy activity, and because I grew up playing video games, many people did question it. Going back to even when my mum was younger and she was at school, she loved to play football, but back then schools didn't allow girls to play football because it was seen as a boy's activity, something that only the younger boys could do. She was never ever encouraged to play football at school, and it's very interesting to me, honestly, the stories that she will tell me sometimes. How the girls were sent off to do sewing or cooking whilst the boys did woodwork or football. And of course I know times have changed a lot since my mum was at school, but I'm still not convinced that we are where we should be with things like this. Children are, of course, very impressionable and will take so much in, whether they know that they're absorbing it or not. A lot of the time I call kids sponges because, to me, that's what they are. They soak up a lot more information and what's happening around them much better than what people perhaps think that they do. They will see these specific colours and toys and TV shows that are associated with their genders and think that that is the only thing that they can be like and that they can do as young boys or young girls. I mean, why can't men wear makeup or boys wear makeup and play with dolls? And why can't young girls and women play with boys' toys or do something that is classed as a manly or boyish thing. These stereotypes for the different genders are somewhat responsible, I think, for raising young girls to think that they should perhaps be stay-at-home mums, and young boys to think that they need to be big and strong and be masculine when they're older. In a way, they're training girls to be mothers and training boys that they have to go to work all day, do the hard labour, support families financially. Of course, times have changed, and I'd like to see more of a change here with marketing towards children and kids. I think for girls, a massive moment of change was the Barbie dolls, as I think that it taught young girls everywhere that young girls aren't just going to grow up to be housewives or mothers. They are much more capable of doing other things, doing whatever they want to do. They could be a teacher, they could be a doctor, whatever they want to do. And I think another big change for young girls was the introduction of strong female fictional characters like Lara Croft and She-Ra, which obviously She-Ra was an attempt to extend the interest in the Masters of the Universe franchise to girls as well as boys back in, I think, the mid-80s. And Lara Croft was obviously a massive, massive influence on the gaming world in particular. I will say, though, that I do think that, you know, I would like to see a lot more equality and less of these gender-focused stereotypes and expectations. But men and women are different. Young girls and young boys are different in their behaviours, in their personalities, in every way possible. But we have to ask ourselves, are men and women, boys and girls, so different because we look at these gender stereotypes and expectations and we shove it down their throats all the time? I believe that does have something to do with it. I believe that it is the fault of those traditional views, stereotypes, expectations, all of that sort of stuff. Now I do just want to talk about articles that I found useful and very interesting on this topic, and as usual, every source that I use to make this podcast will be in the description box down below, so you guys are welcome to check these out if you want to, but I'm just going to bring up some and talk about some now for you guys. So the first article that I want to talk to you guys about is Let Toys Be Toys. And there's a section here on why, as in why do we gender stereotype? So the article reads, stereotyping our children from before birth is to constrain them in a set of rules and expectations which shape the path they will take in their future life, opening up some options and closing down others. It is not an exaggeration to say that unequal wages for women or mental illness in men is, in no small part, connected to gender stereotyping. The toys, clothes, and the attitudes we instill in boys teach boys that men are meant to be tough at all costs, even when those costs are to themselves or the loved ones around them. The toys, clothes, and the attitudes that we instill in girls teach girls that women are meant to be beautiful and caring, and that how they look is more important than what they do, and that their natural place is in the home anyway. It goes on to talk about what we could do as parents, as educators, but of course, you know, I do want to bring up that it is the parents' choice, I guess, whether they want to only dress their baby girl in bright pink with horses and bunnies on the front and unicorns and all that jazz. And it's the same if they have a boy, you know, like, I think that I personally would bring up my child in a way that, you know, if they want to play football and they're a girl, that's fine. If they want to wear makeup or dresses and they're a boy, that's fine. As long as my child is happy, then that's fine by me, as long as they're not, you know, going out breaking the law or doing anything like crazy. Things like putting makeup on and wearing dresses or a girl playing football and things like that, it just
doesn't personally bother me. However, I know that that is just me, everyone's different, but it is, you know, down to the parents, I think. And if you want to only dress your girl in bright pink and unicorns and bunnies and makeup and beauty and all that sort of stuff, then that's fine, I think, if you want to do that. But for me personally, that's just not how I would want to bring up my child, especially if they didn't want, you know, if my child was a girl and they wanted to do the stereotypically the more boyish stuff, I don't see that as a problem. Like I said, as long as they're not breaking the law or they are not, you know, causing trouble in any way, that sort of stuff is fine. I think it is, though, as well, you know, very, very difficult for parents to break free from those gender exclusive stereotypes and those boundaries. And so I think when we're discussing this topic, I think we have to be aware of that as well, because society it's been drilled into society for so long that things have to be this way, and you, if you're a girl, you've got to be like that. If you're a boy, you've got to be like that. Then a lot of people do find stuff that is out of the ordinary weird rather than they embrace it, you know? And I want people to bear in mind as well that children are sponges. I mentioned that earlier in this podcast, but they are. They're so impressionable. They absorb everything that's going on around them a lot more than what a lot of people seem to think that they do. They're a lot more intelligent, even when they're very, very young. They are very impressionable and they're very vulnerable, but their minds and their eyes are open to any possible, like, there's no boundary there, if you're understanding what I'm saying. There's no, like, there's not really anything there stopping them from being a doctor or doing whatever they want to do in their own lives when they get older. I think a lot more people do need to, you know, break free, no matter whether you're a child, whether you're elderly, whether you're just middle-aged, no matter what you are, what race you are, what background you've got. I think we all need to break free of gender stereotyping, gender expectations, gender roles. Because honestly, this is something that really irritates me. But moving on to another article, I found one by the BBC here, and it says, "Gender-specific toys, do you stereotype children? The toys children play with have an impact not only on how they see themselves and on what skills they learn, but also how their brains physically develop. Some physiologists argue that this helps to explain why certain professions are so male-dominated. An increasing number of parents and carers now say that they try to avoid gender-stereotyped play." And I kind of think that that's a good idea, of avoiding gender-stereotyped play, because I don't see why, you know, if I have a son, if I have a boy, why shouldn't they be allowed to play with dolls and with kids' makeup and stuff like that? Like, I would love to have a little boy whose mind was as open as mine is. And it's the same with a little girl, you know? If she wants to play football or do whatever, then that's fine by me. Like, their minds are open to all different possibilities in life, and that is, I think, what matters to me more than anything else with this sort of stuff. But anyway, what do you guys think on this topic? Let me know in the comments section down below. Thank you so much for listening to this podcast. If you haven't checked out my other podcast in this first season, then the link to my podcast playlist will be in the description box down below, along with all of the sources that I have used to create this podcast. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, click on that subscribe button. Thank you so much for listening once again, you guys. At the moment, I am not really sure on when the next season of my podcast is coming out. I've got to sort a few things out before that comes out yet. I'll probably have at least a month's rest of the podcast stuff, but I hope to still see you guys when season 2 of the podcast begins. Thank you so much for supporting the podcast, and I hope to see you guys in my next video.